JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 3rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued trading lower against all but three of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained only against the GBP, Kiwi and the Yen in that order, while it underperformed the most versus the Swiss franc, the Australian dollar and the Euro. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese Yen, combined with the strengthening of the Aussie, suggests that markets continued trading in a risk-on manner yesterday. Nonetheless, the strengthening of the Swiss franc and the weakening of the Kiwi point otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. That said, the picture is mixed here as well. In Europe, the German DAX and Italy's FTSE MIB closed in negative waters, while Spain's IBEX 35 and the UK's FTSE 100 ended their session positive. In the US, both the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 finished slightly higher, but Nasdaq slid somewhat. Asian markets were mixed as well. It seems that some investors remained optimistic over a potential coronavirus vaccine, but others may have started worrying again over the economic effects of the virus's fast spreading, especially after the ADP reported that the US economy has added fewer private jobs than anticipated. Specifically, the figure came in at 307,000, missing expectations of 410,000, something that may have raised concerns that the NFPs due out on Friday may also come in below their consensus, which is at 486,000. UK's FTSE 100 was the main gainer yesterday, with media attributing the gains to Britain's approval of a COVID-19 vaccine, with 800,000 doses of the Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine available starting next week. However, we believe that a huge part of the index's gains may be owed to the pound's tumble. Remember that many companies of the index generate profits in other currencies, so in a weakening GBP environment, if those profits are converted to pounds, they're worth more. The British currency came under strong selling interest. It was found as the main G10 loser this morning, after EU chief Brexit negotiator Michel Barnier said that the main differences between the EU and the UK remain unresolved, adding that a potential trade deal hangs in the balance. With the clock ticking towards the December 31st deadline, all this increases the chances of a no-deal Brexit. In our view, the next few days will be crucial for the pound. Barnier said that talks would be thrust into crisis if UK legislation expected next week includes clauses that breach the withdrawal agreement. In such a case, a no-deal Brexit may become an even more realistic outcome and the currency could fall off the cliff. For the pound to rebound, we need to see headlines suggesting that the two sides have found some sort of common ground over their main differences, which are fisheries, governance and level playing field. Now, passing the ball to the energy sector, oil traders are likely to keep their gaze locked on the OPEC Plus meeting, where members will discuss whether to increase production or extend their existing curbs. After earlier talks failed to result in a consensus, members are resuming discussions today to agree on policies for the new year. Expectations are for a three-month extension of the existing output cuts, but following the rally in oil prices on the positive coronavirus vaccine headlines, some members may have changed their minds, now supporting an output increase. In our view, a three-month extension is unlikely to result in a major movement in oil prices, as this is still the base case scenario. Now, in case the extension is 6 months or more, oil prices are likely to gain, while in case we do get an output increase, we may see a slide. As for the rest of today's events, besides a possible outcome in the OPEC Plus talks, we also have some data releases on today's agenda. During the European morning, we get Eurozone's retail sales for October, which are forecast to have rebounded 0.8% month over month after falling 2% in September. In the US, the ISM non-manufacturing PMI for November is anticipated to have slid to 56 from 56.6, while the initial jobless claims for last week are expected to have to come in close to their prior print. They are expected at 775,000 versus the prior print of 778,000. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.